there, vape fans, and welcome to another video in the Mount Baker Vapor video tutorial series. My name is Lisa, and today we're going to be talking about lithium-ion batteries and battery safety. Now, there is a lot of information out there about lithium-ion batteries in general, so today we're just going to be talking about the information that pertains more to vaping. If we look at this eFest battery here, we have this listed on our site as a 18650 IMR unprotected battery. So let's dissect this information. IMR is just an abbreviation for the type of chemistry that's inside your battery. The I actually stands for lithium ion. Now, most lithium ion batteries use a graphite or hard carbon as the negative host material, but the positive host material can range a little bit more. That actually brings us to the M in IMR. The M will stand for the specific chemicals that are inside your battery, and in this case, it'll stand for lithium manganese oxide. Other chemistries that you may see out there will include ICR, which is a lithium cobalt oxide, and then IFR, which is a lithium iron phosphate. And that actually brings us, lastly, to the R in IMR, which stands for rechargeable. So now that we've gone over what IMR means, we can go over what 18650 stands for. And it actually stands for the size of your battery. So this guy right here is an 18650 battery, and all that means is that it's a 18 millimeter diameter and 65 millimeters tall. And lastly, we can go over what it means when we say these batteries are unprotected. Unprotected batteries are batteries that have no protection circuit built in to protect against common dangers such as overcharge, over-discharge, short circuits, and high temperatures. Protected batteries, on the other hand, are thought to be safer to use, mostly because they're a lot less likely to ignite, a phenomenon called venting with flame, and cause personal or property damage. While unprotected batteries don't have this protection circuit, they do have more capacity and current capabilities than protected cells. Now, if we bring this into the realm of vaping, although these batteries are unprotected, that doesn't necessarily mean they're not safe to use. Any regulated mod that you see out there that's got a circuit board inside has this external protection where the battery itself does not. So if the battery happens to short, the mod will protect you from venting with flame. This is not the case with mechanical mods, so users of these mods have to pay special attention to the batteries they use and how they're using them. One reason that IMR batteries tend to be unprotected is because the chemistry is inherently safe, so the likelihood of having these problems is much lower. Next, we will talk about some general lithium ion and battery safety tips. Lithium ion batteries start degrading the second they leave the factory. They only have about 2 to 3 years after their manufacture date, whether you use them or not. Lithium ion chemistry actually prefers a partial discharge to a full discharge, so avoid taking these batteries below zero. If you recall having to completely discharge a cell phone battery before being able to plug it in again, that phenomenon is called battery memory. Lithium ion batteries don't actually have this memory, so they can get damaged if their voltage drops below a certain level. Lithium ion batteries are extremely sensitive to high temperatures. They can actually degrade much faster in the presence of high heat. If the battery gets hot enough to ignite the electrolyte solution, you're going to get a fire. And when fires like this happen, it's usually because of an internal short in the battery. Lithium ion batteries contain a separator sheet that keeps the positive and negative electrodes apart. And if that sheet gets punctured and the positive and negative electrodes touch, the battery heats up very quickly. Since lithium ion batteries are so energetic, they get very hot. The heat causes the battery to vent the organic solvent used as the electrolyte, and any heat or a nearby spark can ignite it. It's important to note that these fires are very rare, but it is good to know the risks when using these batteries. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. I hope this was helpful. If you have any questions or comments, just leave them in the comments section below, and don't forget to subscribe and share this video if you like it. Alright, we'll see you next time.